sonata form. It is all the traditional characteristics of a multi-movement piano sonata. It has a slow introduction. There's a slow introduction, and then it has a very lively first movement. It has a traditional slow movement. It has a kind of an elfin third movement, a scherzando movement. And it has a kind of a virtuosic, lively final movement, which happens to be the same melody as the first. Now, what is revolutionary about it is that Liszt does not separate these movements. He squishes it all together and creates one massive 30-minute piece. And so there are no breaks in between these so-called movements. An incredible thing is that Liszt only uses five motives for the entire duration of the 30 minutes. And so if you actually go through every single measure of this piece, all the melodies, all the motives will be rooted from one of the five. The first three motives are presented right on the first page as if they're characters in a play. A very recognizable, mysterious descending scale. And then a very defiant motive, kind of like the hero of the novel. Schumann Fantasie with a quote by Clara, but I'll do the same with the Liszt Sonata because the sonata was dedicated to Schumann. And it actually, there is a diary entry by Clara on her receiving the sonata, and she writes, "Remember Schumann, when she received the Schumann Fantasie, she said, oh, I'm still half ill with rapture. And for the sonata, she said, today Liszt Sonata arrived. There's no clear ideas anywhere. It's a mess. And now I have to thank him for it. And if that's not enough," she concludes once again, "it really is too terrible." And so clearly, for many, many years, many decades in fact, musicians, pianists, even a great pianist like Clara Schumann, did not fully understand this B minor sonata. It was too complicated. It was too difficult. And fortunately, today it has really risen in status as one of truly the greatest works for piano ever written.
Thank you. Thank you.